sentry go to chase monotony. He exercises of his brains, that is, assuming that he's got any. Though never nurtured in the lap of luxury, yet I admonish you, I am an intellectual chap, and think of things that would astonish you. I often think it's comical, fa-la-la, fa-la-la, how nature always does contrive, fa-la-la-la, that every boy and every gal that's born into the world alive is either a little liberal or else a little conservative. Fa-la-la, fa-la-la, is either a little liberal or else a little conservative. Fa-la-la.
Just to indulge myself. I'm so touched, so I've been told. It's terrible. I decided against giving the tonight's show like a defined theme because I wanted to allow for a somewhat more diverse set list. So I've got together just some songs that I love, some musical theater, some opera, some folk. Should be a good mix. And I've got some guest performers that have come out and do a duet or two with me, so should be a fun show. The next piece is originally from Mozart's The Magic Flute, but this particular English translation, which is probably the most popular one, actually became something of a modest success for one of the greatest bassists who ever lived, Mr. Paul Robeson. So without further ado, this is Sarastro's aria, Oesis and Osiris.
Lead them to find the path. in their probation.
Like 12, 13 years ago.
We don't talk about
Christ,
that.
I'm old. But no, she's a good friend of mine, and we love performing together. This particular song is actually from a show called Reefer Madness the Musical. If you're not familiar with it, back in the 30s, there was a anti-marijuana propaganda film called Reefer Madness that was not only terribly acted, terribly made, it got nothing right. Nothing at all. It portrayed it almost like it was meth. You were addicted instantly after your first hit, and it made you hyper and violent and horny and just like completely lose your mind. And so in the mid 20-aughts, they made a musical spoof of it which I highly recommend. It's absolutely hilarious. And this particular scene, one of the reefer fiends, Ralph, played by myself, decides to give innocent little Mary Lane her first hit of reefer, and things go exactly as he planned until they don't. So, and if you're wondering why there was a 12 and up recommendation on the poster, it's mostly because of this. So, ladies and gentlemen, Little Mary Sunshine, take it away.
Little Mary Sunshine, with her hem cut so low.
Different.
His way in the dark. mine is the way of the Lord, and those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if they fall as Lucifer fell, the flame, the sword. Stars, in your multitudes, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with water and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. You know your place in the sky, you hold your course and your aim, and each in your season returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as Lucifer fell, you fall in flame. And so it must be, for so it is written, on the doorway to paradise, that those who falter and those who fall must pay the price. Lord, let me find him, that I may see him safe behind the
evening is a very funny comedian. Everybody, Miss Jessica Carter.
Oh. Yeah, get up there.
Now, Jessica and I first met each other through the Nashville stand-up scene and quickly realized that we were both theater people. And yeah, and we've been wanting the chance to perform musically together for a while now. And I knew she was exactly who I wanted for this particular piece. So, whenever people ask me my favorite role I've ever played, hands down, no contest, it is the title role in Stephen Sondheim's Sweeney Todd, the Demon Barber of Fleet Street. And I love that show. I love playing that character. It's such a rich and layered character. I have very strong opinions on the movie, and those who are laughing know them. But what I think a lot of people don't realize, if they aren't familiar with the show, is how funny it is. Because it's a funny show. It's very morbid humor, but it's much funnier than I think a lot of people would expect it to be. And this particular scene, to me, is just one of the biggest indicators of the very warped and twisted sense of humor that Stephen Sondheim and Hugh Wheeler had when they put it together. So this scene is essentially the brainstorming session that Sweeney Todd and Mrs. Lovett have after he has just had a complete mental breakdown. So take it away.
Seems a downright shame.
Shame.
Seems an awful waste. Such a nice plump frame. What's his name has, nor can it be traced. Business needs a lift, debts to be erased. Think of it as thrift, as a gift, if you get my drift. No? Seems an awful waste. I mean, with the price of meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it.
Ha!
Good, you got it. Take for instance Mrs. Mooney and her pie shop. Business never better using only pussycats and toast. Now pussy's good for maybe 6 or 7 at the most. And I'm sure they can't compare as far as taste.
Mrs. Lovett, what a charming notion. Mere and nifty, practical and yet appropriate as always. Mrs. Lovett, how I did without you all these years, I'll never know how delectable. Also undetectable. How choice, how rare. For what's the sound of the world out there?
What, Mr. Todd? What, Mr. Todd? What is that sound?
Those crunching noises pervading the air.
Yes, Mr. Todd. Yes, Mr. Todd. Yes, all around.
It's man devouring man, my dear. And who are we to deny it? These are desperate times, Mrs. Lovett, and desperate measures are called for.
Ah, here we are, hot from the oven.
What is that?
It's priest. Have a little priest.
Is it really good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Then again, they don't come with sins of the flesh, so it's pretty fresh. Where it's sat.
Haven't you got poet or something like that?
No, you see, the trouble with poet is how do you know it's deceased? Try the priest.
Heavenly. Not as hardy as bishop, perhaps, but they're not as bland as curate either.
Ah, and good for business. Always leaves you wanting more. Trouble is, we only get it on Sundays. Lawyer's rather nice.
If it's for a price.
What is something else to follow, since no one can swallow it twice?
Anything that's lean.
Well then, if you're British and loyal, you might enjoy Royal Marine. In a way it's clean, though it tastes of wherever it's been.
Is that squire on the fire?
Mercy no, sir, look closer. Grosser.
Looks thicker, more like vicar.
No, it has to be grosser, it's green.
The history of the world, my love.
Save a lot of graves, do a lot of relatives favors.
Is those below serving those up above?
Everybody shaves, so there'll be plenty of flavors.
How gratifying for once. That those above will serve those down below.
Now let's see. We've got Tinker.
No, something pinker.
Taylor.
Something paler.
Potter.
Something hotter.
Butler.
Something subtler.
Locksmith.
Something.
Lovely bit of clock.
Maybe for a lark.
Then again, they're sweet if you want it cheap and you like it dark. Try the financier. Peak of his career.
That looks pretty rank.
Well, he drank. Now it's bank cashier. Never really sold. Maybe it was old.
Have you any Beetle?
Next week, so I'm told. Beetle isn't bad till you smell it and know this is how well it's greased. Ah, yes. This may be a bit stringy, then, of course, it's fiddle player.
This isn't fiddle player. This is piccolo player.
How can you tell?
It's piping hot. Oh.
Then blow on it first.
The history of the world, my sweet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, what does it tell?
Is who gets eaten and who gets to eat.
And Mr. Todd, who gets to sell?
But fortunately, it's all so clear that everybody goes down well with beer.
Admiral?
Too salty. I prefer General.
With or without his privates. With his extra.
What is that?
It's fop. Find us in the shop. We have some shepherd's pie peppered with actual shepherd on top. And I've just begun. Is a politician so oily, it's served with a doily, not one.
Put it on a bun. Well, you never know if it's going to run.
Try the fryer. Oh, it's drier.
No, the clergy is really too coarse and too mealy.
Then actor, it's compactor.
Yes, and always arrives overdone. I'll come again when you have judge on the menu.
Wait. True, we don't have judge yet, but I've got something you might fancy even more.
And what's that?
Executioner!
Have charity towards the world, my pet.
Yes, yes, I know, my love.
We'll take the customers that we can get.
High born and low, my love.
We'll not discriminate great from small. No, we'll serve anyone, being anyone, and to anyone at all.
Yes, good card, everybody. So, the next song is actually the theme song to one of my all-time favorite movies. So, it's a bit of a personal connection there, but it's also just a damn good song. So, take it away.
Django, have you always been alone?
Songs on the show. Could we maybe pick a different Western?
Sure. How about Blazing Saddles?
Sure, go right ahead.
He rode a blazing saddle. He wore a shining star. His job to offer battle to bad men near and far. He conquered hate. He turned dark night into day. He made his blazing saddle a torch to light the way. When outlaws ruled the West and fear filled the land, a cry went up for a man with guts to take the West in hand. They needed a man who was brave and true. crew, win justice for all as his aim. And now that the sun rode a man with a gun, and Bart was his name. Yes, Bart was his name. He rode a blazing saddle, he wore a shining star. His job to offer battle to bad men near and far. He conquered fear and he conquered hate. He turned dark night into day. He made his blazing saddle a torch to light the way.
Thank you. All right, I believe it's time for our third and final guest. Ladies and gentlemen, Xavier Partridge.
You're not the first person to say that.
Nor is he from the X-Men. So Xavier and I met through a series of radio plays we did that our friend Taylor does called Count Drahoon's Feature of Fright. And we became friends pretty instantly. And this guy is a great singer, a great actor, an incredible artist. And he's actually the first person to ever publish one of my short stories. But most importantly, he's the one who introduced me to my girlfriend.
Aww. Aww.
So,
I've read it.
That's fair. You'll regret a lot more. So from when I was young, even before I started like doing musical theater regularly, one of my first truly dream roles, I want to play that role, was that of the voice of Audrey 2 in Little Shop of Horrors. It is one of my favorite shows. I saw the movie when I was probably 13 maybe, and just was blown away by it. I loved the music. I loved how much personality there was to this villain who's really not even a person. And even before my voice became what it is now, I've wanted to play that role. But I have yet to. Yet. But until then, this is a little snippet, a clipping, if you will, plan pun, of that show. So, go ahead.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Where am I supposed to get it from?
Feed me, Seymour. Me all night long. That's right, boy. You can do it. Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. 'Cause if you feed me, Seymour, I can grow up big and strong. Anything your secret, greasy heart desires. Would you like a Cadillac car? Or a gift shot on Jack Paar? How about a date with a heavy Lamar? You're gonna get it if you want it, baby. How'd you like to be a big wheel? Down and out for every meal. I'm the plan to make it all real. You're gonna get it, yeah. I'm your genie, I'm your friend, I'm your willing slave. Take a chance to feed me, boy. You know the kind I eat, the kind of red hot treats, the sticky licking sweets I crave. Yeah! Come on, Seymour, don't be a puss. Toss me in your mouth, I'll surely rattle King Tuts. Show a little initiative, work up the guts. You'll get it
get chopped up and fed to a hungry plant.
Sure you do. If you wanna rise up now, it isn't very hard to see. No, no, no. Stop and think it all about. A guy sure looks like bamboo to me. A guy sure looks like bamboo to me. A guy sure looks like bamboo to me.
You best be treating her rough.
Alone, narrow streets
streets of cobblestone. Neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking. People hearing without listening. People writing songs that voices never share, and no one dare disturb the sound of silence. Fool, said I, you do not know. Silent like a cancer grows. My words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words, like silent raindrops, fell and echoed in the wells of silence.
And I know if I'll only be true,
quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest, and the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars, still strong with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable stars. Ounce of courage.